everything with Dauphin. Please, I really feel so bad. A lot of people came out when Bill Gates' wife, Melinda Gates, says she saw a lot of bodies on the streets of Africa. We all came out to condemn what she said. But after condemning, what next? What are we doing to ensure that her prophecy does not come to fruition? What I know about prophecy is that when men of God declare something, they pray for it to either happen, if it's positive, if it's negative, for it not to come, if they have seen it. So if Melinda Gates have seen that there are dead bodies all over Africa, and we came out to rebuke it, the world has been saying, what are we going to do? What is the action we are going to follow with to ensure that this thing does not happen? I think Africans are not concerned with this. Somebody say hunger death is worse than coronavirus. Okay, let me tell you, that assertion is not right. Hunger death, you die alone. You're not contaminated. You die with your family. Coronavirus death, you die alone in an isolation center. Nobody is there with you. Nobody is there to hold your hand while you die. You die alone with strangers who are your nurses and doctors. And when you die, your family does not get to bury you. The government buries you because you're a contaminated body. I hear Nigerians saying that, how can you tell us to stay at home when hunger is killing us? When you die of hunger, you don't inflict your family. But when you're contacted with coronavirus and you die of coronavirus, you would have given to your family members. Because immediately it gets to you, you don't even get to know that you have it. It has to be after 3 to few days before the symptoms will start playing. But when, even when the symptoms have not started showing, you can give it to someone. And you know, in Nigerian setting, nobody is in his house alone. We always have family members, even if you're not married. You have family members staying with you. So you cannot die alone. I heard of a man that was giving his survivor of COVID-19. He said he had it, he didn't know. Only for him to start having symptoms, and when they got tested, discover his wife had, and all his children and his mother, everybody in his house has. He just tested negative, came to give his testimony. His wife, he still has it. The children, the mother is an aged woman. Do we know whether she will survive it or not? Would you live with that? But if it's hunger, you will die peacefully. Please. Can we just do the right thing? If we don't do the right thing, that woman's prophecy will come to fulfillment. No binding and casting will help it. When Jesus went to Lazarus' tomb, he said they should roll out the stone. A man that caused dead body that has already started decomposing to come back to life could not do his hand like this for the stone to roll away. He said they should roll out the stone. You will have part in everything that God will have to do in our life, or God is supposed to do in our life. We have part in it. 50% is actually on us, and another 50% is on God. Like Prophet T.B. Joshua will always say, it's not 100% on God. Stay at home. And when you're going out, yesterday I happened to visit a community in Abuja here with the FCT Minister for States to give palliative. Palliative is actually the food stuff that the federal government is sharing to people. There was no social distancing, and the PRO for the Honorable Minister for State was going around to say social distancing, social. Immediately she says it and announces it and pass, people go back closing. Even journalists that are supposed to educate people on this thing. I ran away, I stood very far. I was wearing everything that would protect me internally, because I know the Spirit of God was all over. I went far and stood very far away. And if you come close to me, I will jump, because I don't know where you're coming from. You will say that I was too scared to that level. No. Jesus himself refused to throw himself down. He knew that angels were going to preserve him, just like the devil said. But he didn't do it. He said, thou shalt not test the Lord your God. You cannot see danger and walk into it because you said that the Lord said he will preserve you. No. When you die, he will say, welcome home, my child. Come and sit here. And wait for the day that the trumpet will sound. So we have to preserve ourselves. I fear that if we don't do that, the community outbreak is going to be dangerous. When this virus started at the top, I was expecting that the people under, people like us, would take precautions. But you know, human beings are funny. My people used to say a proverb in a song that if God said he would take away death now, and he put it as a poll for humans to vote, human will say, no, if God take away death, my enemy will not die. So they will vote against taking away of death. It was in a song when we were growing up in my dialect, we used to sing it. Human being will prefer that God should leave death so that at least in hope that their enemy will die tomorrow. This is what is happening. Instead of all of us to come and pray against coronavirus, as people that do not want it prophesied, instead of us to come together as a people and pray against this coronavirus, some people will say, hey, it has started from the top, let it kill all our leaders. And you saw the videos. We made some of the videos and we showed you how Nigerians, instead of them to arrange themselves and say, if this thing is not respectful of even our leaders, it can go through anybody. They just thought that judgment has come on their leaders. But the judgment is on the entire world. And you know, the most annoying thing is that our leaders are the reflection of ourselves. The leader is the reflection of who the community is, because the leader comes from the community. If we don't begin to change our character from our homes, from how we deal with people, from how we treat people, from our offices and our place of work, even when we become a leader, we won't change there. The Bible says that he that is not faithful in the small that he has will not even be faithful in the abundance. That is that. So you can't come and say, until I became a president before. No, the way you treat a visitor in your house, the way you treat your children in your house, the way you treat people at work, that is how you will be as a leader. It doesn't change because you're a leader. No, it doesn't. So as we are throwing stones on these our leaders, that's how we are too. But let's be able to do what the government say we should do. I was expecting that since the thing started on the top, because the community is jam-packed. When we talk about slums in Nigeria, it's not the good neighborhood that some of us are living. I'm talking about the slums. When you have face me and face you, people share toilets. Yes, even in this Abuja, that they share toilets. They queue in the morning. This person goes in and takes his bath, come out, and the next person goes in and takes his bath. How are they going to survive if this thing breaks out in the community? Let's not even talk about rural areas. Rural areas are fine. If you go to rural areas, people stay, they are okay. They pull in the bushes, they do everything they want to do in the bushes. The ones that have toilet, they have their houses, it's well fenced because there is space. But I'm talking about slums within the city where people pay for rent for 40,000 and the five of or six of them have to share toilet. Those are the people that come and serve to us as our cleaner in the office. Those are people that goes to work and do civil service work and what have you not. So we all mix together. If it breaks out in the community, what are we going to do? I was thinking that the community would have been more careful because the thing started on the top. But rather we sat and we were laughing. Laughing and laughing that it should kill them instead of us to arrange our house. There's a saying of my people that if the roof catches fire and the ceiling sits and is laughing and say, it's the roof that has caught fire. It's not me. The roof was acting funny yesterday. Let it burn. Immediately the fire finished with the roof, it will catch the ceiling. I started preparing immediately. This thing was in Wuhan. I knew that if it's not curtailed, the whole world to catch it. And when you got abroad, like I told you my previous year, I was already preparing because I know that something is coming. You can't say, okay, because it's happening to these people. We are all human beings. We are the same. Please, the communities in Abuja, Lagos, Port Harcourt, all the major cities. I'm not talking about the people in the rural area. The people in the rural area are fine because they don't share nothing with anybody. Everybody has his house. They are fine. They can isolate fine. But the people in the city, in the slums, when I'm talking about Abuja, I'm talking about Pape, Nyanya, Lugbe, God, if there's any one person that catches it there, there's a possibility that the entire community will be contaminated. So instead of us to sit and laugh and mock that governors are taking it, the governors even have more chances of surviving. It was alleged that Abba Kyari was flown in, and we saw documents that showed that someone was flown out of Nigeria. You, if it happened, who would try that much to save your life? Forget he's dead today, but who would try that much to save your life? You would die even quicker. I have said that there are so many other things that we need to be taking. Neem leaves is seen to be very medicinal. Why can't you incorporate your meals and some other things you do? Take lemon, take ginger, take a lot of things that will boost your immune system, and then stay at home. Stay safe. Listen to the government. I understand that some people say that it's a game to keep us at home so that some things will be done. It's no game. It's true. We have seen survivors from Nigeria come out and give testimony. The fact that you haven't gotten it is God's grace. Preserve yourself some more. Wash your hands regularly. Even if you're staying at home with your children, once in a while, stand up and wash your hands. There's hypo. It's very cheap. Make sure you clean and mop your house with it. Mop the handle of your doors every day so that what the contamination you had yesterday, you don't recontaminate yourself with it today. Even in your house, make sure you clean and wash your hands at least 20 to 30 times in a day. Anytime, just stand up every minute you feel like, go and wash your hands with soap. Don't go out, but if you must go out to refill some perishable food items, make sure you put on your hand gloves or take your sanitizer. Sanitize your hand regularly. When you buy your food produce, you bring them home, keep them outside, wash them with small salt. After you have removed your gloves from inside out, throw it in the trash bin, wash your hands, turn your distance and pack the nylon, throw them away, the cellophane bag that they pack the food for you in the market, throw them away, wash your home, wash your food produce, keep them outside for some minutes before you can take them into your room. Go straight into the bathroom and wash yourself. Pull the clothes you have gone out with. Please, we need to protect ourselves. Avoid alcohol. Alcohol does temper with your immune system, so that your immune system would be ready. In case you have it, it can fight it. Thank God we don't have much deaths in Africa yet. As of today, we have 17 and we have almost 500 cases and 157 people discharged. We can do better. If this thing breaks out in the community, I don't even know what we are going to do. So please stay at home. The fact that you think it's a rich man's disease is wrong. It's everybody's disease. Going to the rich shows you that it can catch anybody. Please, I beg us, let's take precautions so that Melinda Gates' prophecy will not come to fruition. It's not just about saying, I bind you in the name of Jesus, I rebuke it in the name of Jesus, the mighty name of Jesus, it shall not happen. No, it's about taking steps to make sure that it does not happen as well. Exercise social distancing. I went to the store. A woman was standing at the door. I was supposed to go out. The store has just closed. I and my daughter were the last people that went to the store. A store in Apo. And I asked her, madam, I want to come out. And she said, come out now. I said, no, we are exercising social distancing. Can you step aside? That's my only trouble. But I waited for her. After she shouted and screamed, the security man asked her to step aside, and she stepped aside. I passed. What about I went, a woman and her husband, I don't know what they look like, they are partners. I don't know whether they are married. Married couples now don't wear a wedding ring, so you don't know. But I suspect even if they are not couples, they have intimate relationship. They were standing at my back, and this guy keeps coming and touching me and touching me. And I was like, oh God, please can you stop? We are exercising social distancing. And the girlfriend came for me. That is how much I believe most Africans are not taking this thing seriously. Northern governors have just said that they can't lock down their place, and that is where we have homeless people the most. They are marginalized. So what are we doing? We can't just bind and pray and then not take precaution. It will backfire on us. Please, let's take precaution. If you have something, let's share with neighbors. If you cannot go far, let's share with neighbors. Let's share with neighbors. Let's do everything possible to stay at home. It's safer. Do you know that if we continue to go and we continue to have cases, this thing can linger for 6 months, 1 year. That's when we cannot handle it anymore. But if we listen to government now and we do what we're supposed to do, in the next 1 month at most, because everybody must be isolated for 14 days. After the isolation of 14 days, if nobody has said that they are sick, that means that the country is okay. And if we don't have any new cases, that means the country is okay. But if we continue to go out and keep infecting and meeting people that have it and still taking it, we don't have hope, and it's going to bite hard. The people that you think are sending you 10,000 and 20,000 now, it will get to the point they cannot send anymore, and the government will not have money anymore. So what happened to us? Please, it's better for us to stay safe now. Having said that, this is where I go. This cannot be overstressed. Please, let's do the needful. I love you all, and I'll see you again when I see you. Bye-bye. After the rain, joy comes in the morning. No need to be worried. Brighter days are calling. After the rain, joy comes in the morning. No need to be worried. Brighter days are calling. Joy, I'm living. I'm not doing this. It's better.